German Chancellor Angela Merkel is stepping down at this September's election, and there is no shortage of people looking to fill her shoes. Armin Laschet for Merkel's conservative CDU party, Annalena Baerbock for the Greens. Now, the Social Democrats have chosen their chancellor candidate, a key figure in the German government Grand Coalition. But with the SPD lagging in the polls, does their pick have any chance at all?
Meet Olaf Scholz, now the official chancellor candidate for Germany's Social Democrats, and the man who says, I want to lead a government that moves our country forward, a government that turns ideas into action, instead of being hesitant, doubtful and dragging its feet. At Sunday's party conference in Berlin, he was backed by 96% of the delegates. Scholz is currently Chancellor Angela Merkel's deputy and finance minister. Before the pandemic, he was a staunch defender of Germany's strict fiscal policy. But during the COVID-19 crisis, he pivoted, taking on record debt to safeguard the German economy. But the road to the chancellorship is a long one. The SPD has seen a relentless decline in the polls since the year 2000, from 43% down to just 14% right now. Serving as junior partners in three so-called grand coalitions under Angela Merkel has come at a heavy cost. The SPD is the oldest party in Germany, founded more than 150 years ago to represent the workers' movement. Three post-war chancellors have belonged to the party. The happy days can return, Olaf Scholz is convinced, if the SPD can focus on three big issues.
Respect,
a policy program for the 2020s, and Europe. The SPD is currently ranking third behind the rivals from the Greens and the Conservatives, but Scholz hopes that being the only candidate who served in national government will eventually give him the edge.
With me in the studio is DW political correspondent Nina Haase. Now, Nina, some say the German Social Democrats, well, currently in a coalition government with Merkel's CDU, are doomed. Is that too strong, or what do you say?
There are many people, even within the SPD, who are now speaking of fears that they might not make a two-digit result in September. And if you look at the SPD, you know, I said it in the report, it's the oldest party in Germany. It has a strong tradition. It's firmly rooted. You know, it has 400,000 members still. And so it is something where many people are surprised that they just simply cannot get their message across anymore, and so that they will probably not get a very good result, and that they're even having to fight for third position now, even though they've got this proud history. So, yes, maybe it's good for them to be in the opposition.
So, Merkel's era is coming to an end. Elections are expected in September. What should we expect?
Well, first of all, I think for an international audience, it's important to remember that all the parties that have a realistic possibility of entering the chancellery are still firmly pro-Europe. So that is something that is an important message. All those parties have ruled out governing together with the AfD, that is a very sceptic, anti-Europe, anti-immigration party. But then it comes down to the interesting race of who will actually succeed Angela Merkel as chancellor. And there we're looking at something where the SPD, for the first time in post-war Germany, is not playing a role at the moment. It is going to be between the Conservatives and the Greens. And so, you know, maybe we'll have a young Green woman chancellor, but of course she will also have to find some sort of a coalition partner, and here is where the SPD could ultimately still play a role.
So a lot of mathematics being played with
yeah,
all of
but
this.
It will be interesting.
Yeah. Nina Haase, thank you very much for your time.
You're welcome.